Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
We're going to be making a couple different alcohol ink ornaments. You can use just white ornaments if you already have some and you want to recycle. You can use these clear ornaments. Doesn't matter if it's acrylic or glass. Either one is fine. And you're going to need, if you're going to be using a clear, you are going to need a white paint, just a multi-surface paint that will adhere to whatever you have, glass or plastic, acrylic. You're also going to want something like this, just a piece of styrofoam with some craft sticks in it, so that you can let things turn upside down and dry. You may want to have a couple of cups. I'd say the little paper Dixie cups would be ideal. Plus, you know, paper recycles well. But I had these already on hand, these little plastic cups. And you can also use this little bulb to blow air. It's typically used with cameras and things like that to blow air out. You can use canned air. I think it's a little harsh. The same with, you know, hair dryers and things like that. Or you can just blow through your mouth. Because with alcohol ink, you only have so much control of it anyway. Okay, so the first one we're going to do is going to be on the outside of the ornament, okay? So this is one that's kind of striped. Another one is where I have stamped on it. Okay, just give you a couple examples there of things that's of what they look like when it's on the outside. Here's another one that's got the stripes, but then I come back and stamped at the top. And if we're stamping, that's when you have to have the white, or you have to take your clear, pour white paint inside. I'm not going to make you watch me do that because it would need to dry. And then roll it around or cover the opening and shake it until it's completely coated. Okay, so here's one. Now, it's not completely dry inside. I already know that because when I filled it and turned it upside down and let it drain, it wasn't getting air to the inside, so the bulk is drained out, but it's still damp in there. So once you finish your ornaments, you still want to be able to put them on something for, I would say, 2 to 3 days and let that dry on the inside as well. And but we're going to go ahead and work with it. It's not dripping paint, so we can definitely work with this. So I'm just going to set this out of the way. Oh, you will definitely want gloves on as well. I like the tighter fitting glove for when I'm working with this instead of those looser plastic gloves, but wear whatever you're comfortable with. But we're working with ink, so you just want to keep that in mind. Okay, so I'm going to start with these three colors. It is yellow, purple, and cardinal, which is kind of a pink. If you saw my video before, I think I used these as an example on what they're going to look like for you. Since I had those out, we're going to use these to make an actual ornament. These are also the same brand. Something to keep in mind because, as you saw in the other video, different brands are going to look different. Okay, so I'm going to stick with the same brand, these colors. And I'm not going to put any gold or silver or anything like that in it. I'm just going to stick with these. We're going to be stamping. And so you can buy actual stamps. They're usually wooden, plastic, something like that. And then they have the rough side of a piece of Velcro at the end. When I was first starting out, I wasn't sure I wanted to invest in a lot of the tools. So I just took an empty thread spool and a piece of the Velcro, and I use crazy glue on one end to stick it. This is a smaller one made with two paint lids, and a little smaller piece of the Velcro. And then you can just take a piece of felt and cut squares to fit. And there's no rhyme or reason to this either. Put the ink on however you want to. I'm gonna put a bit blue. On here. I'm gonna put some yellow on the outside. Oops. I'm gonna put a little more green. I want to kind of get out there by the edges and not just keep it to the center. Now the reason I want to keep it to the edge too, I want to get up here around the top of this and go ahead and stamp that so that I can get in there really close. See, it even went up on the neck, and that's fine. Now as I stamp, I'm going to rotate it. And now, just in case there is any paint that would drip out, since it hasn't really had a chance to air dry, I don't want it to puddle and drop out on me. So I'm going to go ahead and put this lid back on. Normally, you know, I would wait till I was done. All right, so, whoops. Okay, lid's back on. And let's pick this up and then we'll do the second row around. Now it's going to expand, especially this cheaper ink. You'll see it kind of spread out and it causes that little edge there. If you don't want to let it spread so much, as soon as you stamp it on, blow on it. And it's going to dry it a little bit quicker. It's ink, so it's going to dry quickly. And you'll start noticing different patterns coming out depending on how you stamp. And I've noticed that the wetter this is and the faster I move, you get less of those little harsh edges. But I think they look good, so I don't mind them and I don't try to get rid of them. Okay, now I want to... And you can see I've got ink on my glove. You want to try to keep them as clean as possible so it doesn't transfer to whatever you're holding. This is the first ornament, so if it's a little blue, that's the color I'm using, so I'm not too worried. And when alcohol ink touches another spot, like this is dry right now, not on me, but as soon as alcohol ink touches it, it reactivates that ink. Or even alcohol. Okay, so now I'm getting down to the bottom half, so I'm gonna switch and hold down at the top of it. As long as it's dry, you can even rest it like on this cup and go ahead and stamp. And then you're going to want to lay this one aside and let it start to dry. So I'm going to find a dry spot on it. Now you can use this after you've got your ink on there. Start at the top. Now this particular ornament, the little top is hard to get on and off. I don't want to break it. So I'm just going to leave it. Now you're going to come in. Normally, I would be using the smaller one as well, but we're going to stick with this. So I'm going to push this right up against the edge, and then I'm just going to drag it down and up, down and up, down and up. I'm going to cover the whole thing. Now this one's pretty wet, so it's not going to give me as much of a streaked look. And that's okay too. I really just wanted to cover the whole thing. Now I want to go back in and see if I can stamp the top. As you can see, everything's kind of ran together, so it's not going to give the same look. But you could always put re-ink it, or even re-ink a new pad to get the same look. But that just gives you a little bit of decoration at the top of the ornament and leaves the stripes at the bottom for you. Where that transferred, I'm gonna go ahead and flip that over because I don't wanna accidentally transfer greens onto this. All right, and now we wanna load this up. Okay, now let's see, I put a little here. I'm going to need another color over with the pink over here just to fill it up. Okay, we're going to come up here to the top, push it all the way up to the edge and rock it. Or you don't have to rock it. I just do. You don't have to. It's pretty saturated. So, and just continue to turn it. And these are more opaque. They have a bit of a sheen to them, but considering they're called metallics, I don't think they really have a metallic sheen. You can see down here, I'm getting more. Oh, okay, I'm just going to stamp over that because I kind of slid it. And then I'm just kind of going around it to see if I didn't want any white showing. So if I see any little white dots showing through, just putting a little stamp on it. Okay, so there's a warmer toned one. Here's one. This is squirting the ink on the inside. Once you have the inside coated with ink, it's going to be hard to see, depending on which brand you're using. So it's almost a surprise, because once you give it some time to dry, then you pour in the white paint. And when you start swirling that white paint and coating the back of what you put in there, if the pattern starts coming through for you. Let's see, here's another one that's alcohol ink on the inside, and then the white paint went in. We've got, here's one that was pretty. They almost look like big marbles, don't they? Drop in the yellow. And you don't have to stripe it. At all. Let me jump in here and move it around a little more instead of just having a stripe. Maybe I want to really move it around. This is where you really want to play with it and just see what kind of patterns are going to come through for you. Grab the pink. I wish I had this brand in orange, but that's okay. All right, now we want to just run that. These you can really see. Now, because if you don't squeeze it when you first put that tip in, there is a gap up here at the top. So maybe I want to grab the pink and come back into it and give it a little squeeze right there at the edge, just so that I'm getting all the way up to the neck. Now, if this was paints, as you can imagine, it would be stacking on top of each other. Since this is inks, they're mingling. So the reason I mention that is if it was paints and you wanted to put some gold in first so that you have the outer layer showing in the gold, and then putting paint on top of that, you know, the gold is not going to move. It's going to be there. Versus with these inks, it may move around. So I'm going to come in here right beside the pink and put a little red. Just a little. And dry that. Then I'm gonna come over here with some red. These you can tell much better, like I know where my clear spots are versus is that a clear spot or yellow. I can tell with this ink what it is. So I'm going to go in with a little bit of pink where this red has split out. I'm going to put a little more pink there instead of yellow because the yellow is coming down right here. Again, no right or wrong. Whatever you think will look good, just play with it. And get in there and move it around so it's not puddling at the bottom. I think that's the biggest thing. You just don't want this big dark spot at the bottom of your ornament from where your ink puddled. I would definitely want to let this dry longer, but for the sake of the video, I also want to go ahead and go in. So, go a little bit heavy on the white paint so it'll cover well. And grab this again. Shake, 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 shake. So you can see how much more opaque this one is versus the other one that we used. These colors hold on. They're not so translucent. They're still translucent, but not as translucent. But that white paint really makes them pop. And see, there's no bright white spot showing through. So I was able to pretty well coat it. You'll see some softer spots where the ink is more translucent, but there's no bright white coming through. Now I'm going to turn this upside down on one of the craft sticks to let that white paint drain out. It's not going to change the look of it at all. It's just going to get that wet white paint out of there. The only time you'll see changes when you turn that upside down to drain is if you've used paint, because that paint's going to continue to be fluid. All right, so I will take pictures of some of these and put at the end of the video, but that's the different ways to use the alcohol ink. Now there is another pretty ornament that we'll do that's only paint. So I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.